Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.
I just want to ask you, Anusha, was it a conscious choice to not study, or did you think that everybody else was better than you, so you should not study?
So his question's a little biased, right? Study is such a small part of what we do and what we learn. Strictly in the sense of the word, I might not have necessarily prepped for the written exams or even stayed awake through the written exams. Like, there are 3 hours exams, okay? Accounting's a 3 hour exam. There's, like, it's impossible. I used to stack up the books and sleep on them. But I actually participated in most of the festivals, in the marketing research festival, etc. But the studying was mostly like, I mean, I entered MBA without an aim, right? It was mostly about, this is the safest thing I can do socially because I have no clue what I want to do. Getting into an IIM will ensure that whatever else I want to do, I have a good safety net to fall back on. So it never really, I think, ended up giving me any motivation to really study when I was there. But I learned a lot, like partially through the amazing network of friends I had and through the other activities. So
yeah. Before Harshil starts, there's just one story I want to share. In the first term of B school, when I would go to his hostel block, I had to go and kind of just meet people, have a chat. And he would always be like, I'm going to study now for the next 2 hours. And then he would sit with the book and start studying. So you're like, okay, I should leave him alone and I'll go and meet some other friends. So about 7-8 minutes after having spoken to somebody else, I would come back and see the Harshil is, by that time, he's lying half on the bed and the book is somewhere, like this. And he's still studying, he's still awake, mind you. And if you come after another 6-7 minutes, the book is on his head, or he's sleeping in a position where he thinks, so he's put the book down on the floor and he's lying upside down, and it feels as if he's reading but he's basically asleep. So that was basically how he studied, and I think the results show.
All right, well, when it comes to studying, I'll start with a slightly contrarian position. I didn't study a lot. But I do think there were certain topics that I should have studied more. Not because they are helping me in my work at all, but purely for the sake of learning and knowledge. My studying was very dependent on the professor. So if I would like the professor, if I would find the professor interesting, then I would really, really study. And there are a few courses that I still remember that I really put everything into those courses, simply because I loved those courses. More because of the professor rather than the course content. So I think you might hear a lot of cool stories in terms of "Arey kuch nahi padhai kya, maza aaya," all of that. But I think about it from the perspective of learning. You don't know how much is really going to be useful, right? So whatever you like, go ahead, do. I wouldn't recommend that don't study, but do what you like. And as Anusha mentioned, even for me. Right at the word go, B school was insurance. So I was thinking about it from that perspective that, hey, if I have this degree, at least I have a good fallback. I have some decent name on my resume. So no matter what I do, no matter what I explore, and I actually did end up doing that, move around here and there, try different things, at least I have something to fall back on, which actually worked out well for me.
However, looking at their professional career, okay, what is common between the two of them is that they both got into consulting from campus, despite being in the bottom. We were good enough to get jobs, for sure. They actually, after the first job, took a pay cut and went and worked in startups. This is, I'm talking about, the years 2011-12. Today, for example, startups and the entire halo around them is very common. But back then, smartphones had just started becoming the norm. For example, I remember Anusha was a huge, Android geek back then. There were probably only 5 people on campus who would have a smartphone back then, and she was one of them. A lot of us just had very simple feature phones, or Nokias were still existing at that point of time. And I don't know what they saw in the future, but they both decided that, you know, they would probably okay to take a pay cut and go to a startup. Or so, for example, Anusha actually decided to do an internship in UI and UX, which I don't think is connected to MBA at all, you know, in many ways. At least back then, it didn't seem like it was connected. And she was almost out of a job for a while, and then she decided to go and join a startup. Harshil was at one point, and he's actually an ex-entrepreneur as well, so all the guys who are talking about entrepreneurship, you should definitely catch up with him around that. And he had this thing he wanted to probably start a company of his own or maybe join a startup. So guys, what made you actually decide to take a pay cut? Was there any kind of insecurity that you're earning less than your batchmates? I think it's a very courageous thing to do, to be able to actually, at that age, because there is social pressure as well. Your parents are asking you, there are relatives saying, oh, you went to an IIM and where are you working now? Or you're not working at all. So what was your journey like? So I'll start with Harshil first and then we move on to Anusha.
So after campus, I got placed at Wipro Consulting. I spent 1 year there, learned some interesting things, but definitely not something that I wanted to continue doing. At that point of time, in parallel, I was working on one small venture called guitarbajao.com. It was more of something that, I like playing the guitar, I play music, there is a certain problem that I see in the market, let's go and solve it, right? That's all I was thinking about. Now, I worked on it for a year and then I decided to shelve it because while I was working at Wipro, I decided then this doesn't make sense, right? So I shut it down. Then I thought, the one thought process that was fairly clear in my mind at that point of time was, hey, if I don't do this, now that I'm shutting guitarbajao.com, what do I do next? So I said, you know what, let me do the next best thing, which is work with an early stage startup and learn how things work, right? I mean, I'm not doing anything. I'm not learning by myself. Let me see how things go. That time, I didn't really think about technology sector or product management. In fact, product management did not even exist back then. None of that. I just thought it'll be interesting to learn some procedure. I shortlisted a startup and then I decided to go and work there. The one thought process that I had back then and still have now is that it is very easy to optimize for your incomes and for everything because you're talking about pay cut. In the short term, right? You can say that, hey, tomorrow I will do this and hey, 10% raise or 20% raise tomorrow and so on. But optimizing for a 5 year later income is much harder and it's not really intuitive and you don't know what will happen. So the one thing that I wanted to do was, I want to optimize for, of course I want money, I love money, but I wanted to optimize for money after 5 years and not after 1 year. I mean, things didn't really pan out the way I wanted, but somehow things worked out well.
Can you also tell them what you did next? So after, what was the name of the company you joined? And just a very brief career, so how did you reach here now?
Oh, okay. So after that, I worked with an early stage company called MyShadi.in. It was just a 4-member team. One small round of funding, which is in today's world, like that small amount means nothing. At a time when startups really meant nothing. So I went and joined. I moved cities. I went to Delhi, a city that I used to hate back then. But I do like Delhi now. Delhi has it. Because I was always more of a Pune-Bombay guy. So, I learned a lot of things there. I mean, how to operate in that environment when there's absolute uncertainty. After that, I moved to Bombay. That was mainly because I want to get married. My wife was in Bombay and then we decided, hey, Bombay should be the place where we should end up for life. And that was a final decision, of course. and then I moved to Bombay and then I moved to another startup because I wanted to continue the journey. I was like, hey, you know what? I had to leave right now, but I want to do something similar. I worked with another startup, which was an e-commerce startup back then in Bombay.
What was it called?
The Label Corp. Again, interesting experience, but what happened then was we couldn't raise the next round of funding because, again, back then, funding wasn't like how it used to be. You raise $1 million and it's like, oh, wow, that's pretty amazing. And we couldn't raise the next round of funding and then that company is still doing well, by the way. They're really doing well now. I just interacted with the founder very recently. Celebrities are brand ambassadors over there. Yeah, Malaika Arora, Bipasha Basu, Suzanne Roshan Khan. So these were the three brand ambassadors and clothing, home, multiple things. Check it out. So then that is when I decided that I'll move on and I'll work. And by then I had figured out, hey, what I really like doing is something that is called product management. And I think it would be interesting to explore that further. And if I want to explore that further, I should look at the companies that do product management in the best way. And back then, 2013, 2014, there were just a few really, just a handful of companies in India and mostly MNCs. And Flipkart was still new back then. I didn't even know about product management at Flipkart back then. So then I joined a larger company called Intuit, well known for customer obsession, design thinking. You might end up doing a case or two on Intuit sometime in B school. And then after that, yeah, another move and I ended up at Flipkart.
So after Intuit, you joined ClearTax. After ClearTax, you joined Flipkart. So we'll come back to why you make so many exits soon. I think it'll be interesting for people to know. What is your story? So you were in Deloitte. So what happens next?
So the team I joined in Deloitte, right? It was this team called Innovation Consulting. It sounded fancy. What it was trying to do is look at the consumer trends and see how they could be monetized in the enterprise space. Very early on, I realized it was not for me. Even during MBA, I was a sort of this lost soul who was good at certain things but could never sort of string it together to figure out how to make money off it in the real world. In the consult, while I was in innovation, right, Deloitte Innovation, I happened to do this one project called gamification. Like this big buzzword starting in 2011-12 onwards, right? It didn't take, right? Like a lot of people were like, we get most of our money from a certain set of services. Pushing gamification down the throat of our clients is a difficult thing to do. So we had to build something internally to convince them of it. So I ended up building this Excel dashboard. So it was a website that ran in Excel, which is when something clicked. It was like, I like building these kind of things, figuring this out. What also happened at the same time was, you know, this company called Rovio, right? Angry Birds. So I had this grand idea for them. Right, like we all have ideas for the games that we love. So I went to the website to submit the idea. As I was submitting it, I was looking at the job descriptions there. And there I saw experience design, right? Like solving for the user, thinking from a user's point of view. And that really stuck with me. Right? Back then in India, those roles were not really there. You did not have full-blown product management at all, except in some pockets like ISB, Microsoft hired from there. That was pretty much it. It's like I have to get into this UI UX design. The options for me were very simple. Either I take up this course called HCI in CMU, or I figure out something else. And I knew I'm not somebody who's good at a 2-year, 3-year sort of a learning, right? More like do things and learn. So then I looked around for options. Internship, is there something I can do? Is there some company? And this is where all the small connections that you make really come and help you, right? So I used to keep talking about these things with everybody that I have to figure this out. Somebody knew somebody who was in the UX department in Microsoft. And they connected me. And I still remember that entire conversation, right? He's like, so I gave him a portfolio. So I sketch and draw and I did websites for the college fests and things like that. He was like, are you sure? Like consulting, you make a decent amount of money. Do you really want to leave that and come and do an internship? The internship paid about 22,000 per month then, right? And that was about like 1/3 of the salary I got in hand. I was like, yeah, I'm pretty sure, 6 months. He's like, there's no job guarantee after this, right? I'm like, theek hai. They decided to take me because they thought it would be a very interesting experiment to get somebody who's done an MBA, has some interest in this to come in. And I was an experiment, right? Like I was experimenting with their life, they were experimenting with the program. Unfortunately, I had an accident about a month into the program. Right, which I now see as a boon, because of which I couldn't continue the learning that I was taking forward, but it lit that small fire in me. I also realized that design was not my thing. Right? Design was really deep into one thing, and I really love technology. Like, again, 2011, Android phones, how many of you know XDA? Right? So ROMs back then were really, like, it was really difficult to actually load a ROM, right? You had to do like 1,000 steps, and the number of times I've bricked phones, I know. Like I've bricked phones sitting in coffee shops, okay. So I knew I wanted a combination of tech and this. So there was this one small startup doing something interesting in India back then. It's called Dexetra. I joined there. I was the first product hire. So everybody was learning product management at the same time, right? Had a great stint there. Got acquired by another company in the Bay Area, after which I moved to Flipkart. Right? Flipkart, I joined the monetization team. So it was basically this whole desire to build, right? Like, I couldn't build a slide deck. Like, that was not me. I knew it. A couple of interesting things here, right? So one is, Harshil and I, we both took our own paths. We both arrived at product management at the same time.
Around the same time. All of this, yeah.
Yeah. From very different paths, we came together. And we were like, product management, yay. And it really helped because you had somebody else to talk to about it, right? Like, because nobody else really understood it. Consulting, yes. Bank mein jana, yes. You know, all these sales, marketing, people understand all these things. You say product management, they're like, what are you talking about? Like, what do? Right? Marketing, product marketing manager, yes, we understand. What is this product manager, right? And it's not like you are in touch with your tech roots. So what are you going to do? So it was really helpful to have somebody, and actually one more friend was also there, right? Like, have this set of people who understood what you're talking about and really, you know, sort of helped along the journey.